Welcome to the Defense and Aerospace Report. I'm Vagha Maradian here at the Surface Navy Association's annual conference and trade show, number one gathering of surface force leaders from around the world. Our coverage here is sponsored by GE Marine and Leonardo DRS. And we're here at the GE Marine stand to talk to my friend George Avizas, who's a business development director at GE Marine, and Steve Mankovich, who is with GE Power Conversion, also does business development there. George, let me start with you. Integrated power has been something that's been discussed here, whether for the new large surface combatant. We heard Rear Admiral Gene Black, the N-96, the Director of Surface Warfare, talk about that, and also how important integrated power is going to be to a new generation of unmanned platforms. You guys are obviously best known for the LM-2500 that powers ships in dozens of navies around the world, but you guys are also have been putting a lot of investment in what that integrated power solution for the future looks. If you look at it at DDG-51, for example, is 9 megawatts. If you look at a Flight 3, it's about 12 megawatts, whereas if you go to DDG 1000, it's 88, I think almost 90 megawatts of power in there. Talk to us a little bit about your thinking and approach and the kind of programs that are ongoing and how you guys fit into that.
Yeah, and well, thank you, Vagha. Yes, Rear Admiral Black did mention here at Surface Navy relative towards the large surface combatant, and that will be coming later on in this decade. And it's all about power. As you mentioned, on DDG-51, the Flight 2s were 9 megawatts, 12 megawatts on Flight 3. They're going to need more than that. So the ship is really constrained. And it's all about size, weight, and power capability. And we can do that with our gas turbine generator sets, but it's all about two things. Is first, having the equipment, and then also the power management system to rapidly take loads and reject loads. And that's why we have our partners here, Power Conversion, so we as one GE have the combination, the motors, the drives, the power management system, gas turbine generator system. The Navy's looking for a solution, not just box equipment. It has to work functionally. For this ship is going to be 30, 40 years old, and it's going to have advanced radar. Look what they had to do on the Flight 3. They redesigned 45% of the ship just to get that 3 megawatts. With a full electric system, you can take substantial amount of power, and the only thing you lose is top end speed. If you were to do that with a mechanical system or a hybrid system, you couldn't do it. And so that's what we're bringing to the Navy, is that solution.
And if you guys think about it, you guys have a long heritage of also shore-based power, since you guys develop power plants, and a warship consumes as much power or could power a small or medium-sized city. Steve, let me bring you into the conversation. As you guys are looking at these opportunities, especially for large displacement and medium displacement unmanned systems, they're also going to be very power-hungry. Navy wants to put lasers, rail guns. That's going to put a power premium as well. What's the kind of thinking that you guys have in how these integrated power systems for unmanned would be developed? Because as we've talked to a number of companies down here on the show floor, all of them have said that you really have to have a ground-up approach, given that these systems are going to be autonomous or semi-autonomous or optionally manned.
Yeah, absolutely. That's a great question. I think with any of these new future unmanned systems, the key, the biggest key, is having a high reliability system and a high availability system. So one of the things we do at GE, we really focus on making sure that our systems come together as an integrated piece of, it's not just one individual piece, but as a total system. So I think we look at it from a systems perspective. We think about unmanned, its reliability, but also it's the digital side. It's having predictability and availability and being able to look out forward in advance to find out, will this ship be able to go on its next deployment? How long can this ship stay out? So that's one factor. Another factor is also having a system that is fuel savings, whether it's adding an energy storage, so these vessels can stay out for a much longer period of time. And I think when those all come together, clearly we have an advantage, because we do provide the systems, but we're also developing battery systems. We're also we have state-of-the-art digital systems that have predict capability, smart signal, all the things that are going to be required to have an unmanned system of the future.
And you guys are really looking at it from an end-to-end standpoint. Generally, there's a sense, George, that when you're looking at GE, you're looking at something that's like much larger and gas turbine powered. But you guys are looking at a whole bunch of other options as well in order to be able to generate that power for smaller platforms as well. Talk to us a little bit about your architecture that you're looking to be sort of modular and much more flexible.
Well, one of the things is we have gas turbines that are multiple sizes. So first of all, for the largest sizes, we have 22, 26, and 30 megawatts that give options to the Navy. And of course, those are for larger ships. But we also have gas turbines in the 4 megawatts. And then, therefore, also in some of the unmanned, there may be diesel electric and electric plants. And that's really, you know, my partner Steve Mankiewicz's job is those integrated power systems where we can take the electrical load and manage those systems.
Are you guys looking at other sorts of hybrid power? GM Defense is one of our sponsors as well, and they're focusing on batteries, but certainly hybrid hydrogen fuel cells and other things. Are you guys like looking at a wider aperture of things that would be able to power future ships, especially when, for signature management reasons and others, you may want to go electric for longer periods of time, for example?
Yes, absolutely. So, you know, one of the things about on the U.S. military side, it's typically about non-developmental proven technology. So we'll put that to the side, but certainly in the areas where the commercial side goes much faster. So we are developing hydrogen fuel cells technology, mainly for the cruise line market and for some of these sort of the commercial side. What we hope to do is develop it in the commercial side and the industry, and then once we can take it, we can improve upon that. Improve the reliability, you know, whether it's a shock-rated ship, and make it conform more to the military standards. But absolutely, we are looking at alternate power sources, whether it's hydrogen, lithium-ion battery, or other types of fuel.
All right, and let me ask the most important question of George, given that you are one of the biggest cheerleaders for Red Sox Nation. Some challenges, obviously, over the last couple of days regarding the broader investigation across Major League Baseball about signal stealing. So are you going to throw your hat in the ring to become the next manager of the Boston Red Sox franchise?
I will. If all of Fenway Park can pronounce Visas, I will become manager. So thank you.
Wishing you a good season. George, thanks very much. Director of Business Development from GE Marine, and Steve Mankiewicz, who is the Business Development Director with GE Power Conversion. Guys, thanks very, very much. Really enjoyed the conversation. Good luck on becoming manager, because I think you deserve it.
All right. Thank you, Vargo.
Thank you, Vargo.